Hello, good morning students. Today we'll clear the concepts of Neartic realm. Neartic realm is basically having the Greenland, Canada, USA and Mexico. This region is divided into four sub-regions. Number one, California sub-region. California sub-region is basically demarcated on the sides of the North America. Next to California is Rocky Mountain sub-region. It includes mountain of East California with fauna like goat, prairie dogs and lizards. Allegheny sub-region, it includes Rocky Mountain sub-region, lakes of eastern parts of USA, vampire bats, star-nosed mole, opossum, turkeys, Carolina parrots, they are present here. Canadian sub-region, it includes remaining part of North America and Greenland. Bison, polar bear, Arctic fox, reindeer are commonly seen. So, the individuals of Neartic realm are Steeler sea lion is also present along with the Neartic realm, Palearctic realm and Neotropical. Males rarely live beyond their mid-teens, whereas female can live as long as 30 years. Adult male establish their territories and aggressively defend them. Steeler sea lion regularly travel great distances, 250 miles per day, to find the food. Food is basically the fish, maybe herrings, salmo, cod, rockfishes. The ear of steeler sea lion are visible and are turned downwards so that water does not enter into it. Steeler sea lion have large bulging eyes and flat square nose. They have long whiskers which is used to navigate underwater and find prey. Next individual is mud puppy, Necturus. Mud puppies are aquatic salamanders that grow to about 1 foot in length. They retain their gills throughout their lives. Mud puppy are found in southern Canada, throughout Midwest and southern United States. Mud puppies seek out small lakes and streams with slow moving water and rocky beds. Mud puppy diet is small fish, invertebrates like crayfish, snails, worms. While mud puppy have lungs, they are rarely used for respiration as these creatures spend almost their entire life underwater. Bright red gills of mud puppy is responsible for extracting oxygen from the cool water. So, steeler sea lion and mud puppy, these are the two individuals. Next, star-nosed mole. Mole, as you know, strong claws they are present for digging. Star nose helps them to sense things. The nose of these species act as a powerful sensory organ because these helps them to see. The brackish brown fur of these species help them to be warm during winter. This prevents freezing of their body. The tentacle of these species help them to feel the electric pulse from their victim while the brain function at a very rapid speed. They can swim long distances to find the prey. These species are active during day and night. The tail of these species preserve fat. They prefer to live together, forming colonies. And the main food is ants, beetles, snails, mollusks. Predators, they are hawks, skunks, owls, weasels and snakes. Next is moose. Moose are largest member of deer family. Males are known as bulls. They have huge antlers. They can shed antlers each winter, which is different from the other deer antlers in shape. Moose are solitary and do not form herds. The moose mating season is in the autumn. The moose is large, heavy, and with massive heads and long nose. They have short tails and a hump on the shoulder and large ears that can rotate. Moose can move through deep snow with their long legs. Good sense of smell and hearing, but are not noted for their eyesight. Lifespan is almost 15 to 25 years. They live in many places of forest around the northern hemisphere. Some moose lives in North America in places like Alaska, Canada, Rocky Mountain, Colorado. They are good swimmers. Next is beaver. Status is least concern. Beaver possess set of transparent eyelids which enable them to see in water. They are second only to humans in their ability to manipulate their environment. Beaver home or lodges are dome-like construction built from branches and mud. They are positioned in open water for protection from predators and have underwater entrance holes. They are among the largest rodents on the earth. Their large rodent teeth never stop growing. The beaver constantly gnawing on wood keeps their teeth from growing too long. Beavers use their tail to pat down mud while constructing their dams and lodges and to slap the water as warning of danger and warning to keep away. The tail stores fat and, because it is nearly hairless, releases body heat, helping the beaver to regulate its body temperature. Next individual is reindeer or caribou. Least concern. Animal is semi-domesticated. Males lose their antlers in winter or spring, but females shed in summers. Females are significantly smaller than the males. Reindeer are only mammals that can see UV light. Reindeer are ideally designed to live in cold environment. Their fur traps air, which not only helps them to provide excellent insulation but also keeps them buoyant in water. Reindeer are species of deer whose natural habitat is far northern area of Arctic Europe, Asia, North America, near the tundra, above the tree line. They are named in North America as caribou and in Europe as reindeer. Next individual is loons, gavia, least concern. Loons spend their days feeding, preening, resting and caring their young. Their diet is mainly fish, eats on sunfish, smelt, minnows, catfish, crayfish, frog, leeches, snails also. Loons, the ducks, the geese are water birds, but they are classified separately. Their closest living relatives are penguins. Loons sometimes spend long periods resting motionless in water. Adult loons may fly to different lakes to feed, but adaptation that makes loons such efficient divers also make them heavy and slow to take wing. At night, loons leap over deep water away from land for protection from predator. Next individual, very important individual, is Gila monster, nearly threatened. Largest lizard in the United States. One of the few species of venomous lizard in the world. The skin consists of many round bony scales, a feature that is common amongst the dinosaur but is unusual in today's reptile. Gila monster has striking bright pink and black coloration. The skin consists of many round bony scales. Gila monster spends a large proportion of their time underground in burrows, hibernating during the winter, sheltering from midday sun in the summer months. It emerges from hibernation in spring, and majority of their activity occurs in the following 3 month periods. Eggs they are laid in depression dug into the soil. This is poisonous lizard, Gila monster. Next is Salmo, status least concern. The fish is soft fin rays, short dorsal fin and fatty fin, teeth in their jaws. Young Salmos has spotched color on its sides for first 3 years of life, and then they turn silver when it leaves the ocean. Upon returning to its native river to reproduce, the Salmo turns black. The head of female Salmo is streamlined throughout the lifetime. The young Salmo will stay in the river where it was born for first 1 to 3 years of its life. It will then leave the ocean and return only to spawn. Adult Salmo are excellent jumpers and can ascend rapids to reach fresh water. They have been known to cover 3200 kilometers to reach their spawning ground. Atlantic Salmo are able to spawn more than once, but some dies of exhaustion after breeding. Pacific Salmo reproduce only once and die shortly after. Next is Scarlet Macaw, least concern, colorful. It lives in humid evergreen forest in American tropics. It is large, colorful parrot that lives in Central and South America. Sexes are alike. The individual gather in flocks to sleep at night, but maintain a monogamous pair bond for life. Mostly found in pairs in their nest or flying together. Once paired with mate, they are rarely found alone except to feed when one bird must incubate the eggs. Nests are made in hollowed areas of tree. Scarlet macaw use their left foot in handling food and in grabbing other things. They communicate with variety of vocalization and postures. Scarlet macaw have excellent vision and hearing. They can live for 75 years. So this is how the distribution of different individual is there. First is Steeler sea lion. Steeler sea lion, it is present in Nearctic as well as Palearctic realm. Next is mud puppy. Mud puppy is in USA. Then is Starlow's mole, part of Canada and USA. Then moose, Canada, a small part of USA where Rocky Mountain is present. Then is beaver, Canada as USA. Reindeer, Canada. Loons, Canada. Gila monster, part of USA and Mexico. Salmon, part of USA and Canada. And scarlet macaw, Mexico. So this is how their distribution is there on the map. So one by one you are going to draw. So this is regarding the Nearctic realm. I hope the concept, the distribution, the individuals, they are clear to you.